Welcome everybody on a session about protection, different virtualization platforms like Red Hat, KVM, Xen, OVIRT, Aura Virtualization, Nutanix, Proxmox, OpenStack. We will discuss today how to backup, how to recover those platforms, those virtual machines. The hero of our meeting will be Dell vProtect, the solution that allows us to backup and restore those virtualizations. My name is Daniel Olkowski and I deal in Dell Technologies with backup recovery solutions. One of them is Dell vProtect. Agenda for today, we will discuss what is vProtect. We discuss functionalities, of course, and architecture. This will be a main part. We will talk also about the interface. We'll make a live demo. We will talk about the trials. We will say how to try the vProtect in our environment. I will show where to find more materials. Of course, we'll summarize everything and we'll talk about licensing as well, which is a huge important part, of course. What is vProtect? So vProtect is a backup recovery solution, which task is to protect virtualization platforms like Nutanix, like Citrix, Red Hat, KVM, ORAC Virtualization, OpenStack, OVIRT, Proxmox, Xen. So the goal of the vProtect is to provide backup recovery solution, backup recovery possibility for all the virtualization platforms other than mainstream VMware or Hyper-V. Let me start from vProtect architecture. How the vProtect solution is designed, how the solution should be implemented in our environment. As we have said, vProtect provides backup recovery for different platforms, Nutanix, Red Hat, ORAC Virtualization, OVIRT, OpenStack, Xen, KVM, for different virtualization. And it just takes images of virtual machines, it takes the images of virtual machines and send them to one of the two possible backup media. This is a data domain. And in this case, we have sourced the duplication because the data are sent via BoostFS, via source the duplication, okay? Or it can be just a regular disk, which will be a local disk or remote disk, it doesn't matter. What is the difference between using a data domain as a target media as a disk? As we have talked, vProtect protects virtualizations, different virtualizations. So it takes images of virtual machines and sends to backup media like data domain. Then we have a source deduplication with BoostFS or to the disk and they are just all the data they are sent. If we have a disk as a target media, then vProtect backup is two-phase backup. First, the virtual machine, for example, of Proxmox or Nutanix is taken and written locally on vProtect node, and then it's read and sent to target disk, okay? So we read image of virtual machine, write locally on a disk, then we read from the disk and send to the target destination disk. Okay, so this is two-phase backup. Even if the target disk is local for vProtect node, this is still two-phase process. If we have as a destination data domain, then this is one-phase backup. vProtect reads the image of virtual machines, performs source deduplication with BoostFS, and sends directly to data domain, physical or virtual. So it's just much shorter because this is one phase backup and also we use BoostFS source the duplication. Let's have a little bit closer look, okay? So we mentioned that vProtect provides a backup of different virtualization, Nutanix, Citrix, Red Hat, OVIRT, others. So, and it can use two type of a media. It can be a disk. Then this is two-phase backup. It can be a data domain, physical or virtual. This is one-phase backup in this case. But if we want to implement vProtect for test or production, we need to have vProtect server, which is essential backup server for vProtect. And we need to have nodes, just the workers. They just provide all the job, all the backups. We can compare them to media server, to storage node, to proxy, okay? vProtect server, this is essential management. This is a GUI interface, command line interface, REST API interface. It provides all the interfaces, okay? vProtect node just gets orders from vProtect server and backup. For example, this Nutanix virtual machines, two Citrix virtual machines, three Red Hat virtual machines, four OVH virtual machines, okay? And he just reads the image of the virtual machines and sends to the target media data domain on a disk. We have always one vProtect server because this is central solution. But we can have one node or many nodes because, for example, we have many virtual machines, hundreds of thousands. So we can have a lot of nodes. So the solution is scalable, okay? We can just add additional nodes to have more performance. We can also add processor and memory to the node, also to increase its capabilities of reading the images and sending to the target media data domain or a disk. Okay, so we have a scalability. From the installation perspective, vProtect is just binaries that can be installed on CentOS or Red Hat. So if we backup Nutanix, it can be just virtual machine on a Nutanix. And vProtect server, binaries, and vProtect node, if the installation is small or test, it can be installed on the same virtual machine. So for example, we can have an additional Nutanix virtual machine for vProtect server and vProtect node. Or we can have on another virtualization, we can have this additional node, or we can have a physical event server when there'll be vProtect server and vProtect node, okay? So it can be installed anywhere, usually installed on the protected platform, yeah? Because some of the platforms even quiet the node will be installed on them. Is the node an appliance image? So the question from Mohammed, both node and both server, these are just installable binaries. These are just installable binaries, okay? Let me show you. If you go to Dell page, drivers and download to vProtect section, you can download vProtect installation package. And you can install on any CentOS, on any Red Hat, you can install those binaries, okay? So they are just installable on any virtual machine. Binaries can be installed on any virtual machine, which is CentOS or Red Hat, and this is for both vProtect server and vProtect node, and both of them, they can be the same server, virtual or physical, if the installation is small or if this is test installation. A question from Basel, is it a part of PowerProtect Data Manager or this is standalone solution? So currently PowerProtect is a standalone solution for protection of different virtualizations like KVM, Xen, OpenStack, Oracle, Proxmox, Citrix, OVIRT, Nutanix, Red Hat. Question from Fabrice, do we have VLAP already available for vProtect? Yes, Fabrice, the VLAP is absolutely available. So if any of us have access to democenter.dell.com, there is in data protection section, there is a ready to use Dell EMC vProtect lab where we can check, test, and enjoy the vProtect, okay? So this is absolutely available for all of us. Let's go to functionalities. So first of all, as we said, we can backup images of different virtualization, Xen, KVM, Red Hat, Nutanix, Oracle, others, okay? We can backup images. So vProtect does not require any agent inside the hypervisor or inside the virtual machine. This is image level backup. Sometimes it is required that the node will be installed on the hypervisor platform. It depends on the hypervisor capabilities, okay? So the whole backup is based on the API provided by particular virtualization. So again, we don't install any agent inside the virtualization. But apart from the regular backup that we perform an image level backup, that we take the image from Proxmox, OVIRT, Red Hat, and others, we can take the image and send to data domain or a disk. We can just create a snapshots and they will be kept on the Xen, they will be kept on the KVM, okay? So vProtect is able to just make snapshot of protected virtual machines and keep those snapshot directly on the virtualization, directly on Xen storage, Red Hat storage, and so on. So it gives us a huge value because we can have very often backups, like even 15 minutes. We can immediately recover because it's just reverting the snapshot. Also, we can restore to very recent point of time, like 15 minutes. But please remember that this kind of a protection does not give us the protection against all failures. It only gives the protection against human error, that someone has deleted a file, database, virtual machine. But if there is a complete crash of the server, then absolutely all the snapshots, they will be crashed as well. Yes, so we will not be, you know, we will not have snapshot, we will not have a backups. So I would say that snapshot management is add-on to image level backup, to separate backup media like data domain or a disk. Okay, but this is fantastic thing, because even for VMware or Hyper-V, there are very few solutions that provides snapshot management, and they are able to make a VMware snapshot, Hyper-V snapshots, and just keep them and allow us to restore from those snapshots. From the snapshot, we can restore just the state of the virtual machine. Okay, so it's also wide range of the capabilities. Here we see the possibility to set up the snapshot management. For example, we see here the rule that we want to keep, for example, 3 versions of the snapshots, or we want to keep the snapshot for 4 days. So what we see that vProtect allow us to retain backups based of number of versions, like for example, we have TSM spectrum, or we on based on a time, like we have in the networker, NetBackup, other backup solutions, okay? We can choose any of them. And guys, this is really something which is fantastic. Automated policy assignment. vProtect provides self-backup infrastructure. So I can say to vProtect, hello vProtect, please backup my whole Proxmox, Red Hat, Oracle, Nutanix environment every day at 6 p.m. And he will automatically backup all previous virtual machines as well as the virtual machines that were added today. So there is not required that, for example, administrator of the OVIRT calls me and say, Daniel, I have added 2 virtual machines. For example, I am on the way in my car and I say, okay, so I will add them tomorrow. Or for example, he added 2 virtual machines, but he didn't tell me. So in such a case, if I don't add those virtual machines, you know, I will not be myself check all the, you know, KVM environment or the Red Hat environment. I will not checking myself. Maybe there will be some virtual machines that are not backup. And if there is required to restore them because ransomware has attacked them or something else happened, then he will say, Daniel, please restore me those virtual machines. But I will tell him, I don't have an email request to backup these virtual machines. But he will tell, you are a backup man. I need to tell you that you need to backup. You are responsible for backup and you need to tell you that you should backup our environment. So this is a discussion that does not lead to, you know, any conclusion. This is a discussion that does not make sense. So self backup environment is a huge value. It's a fantastic thing. And in my opinion, this is one of the best, you know, even, you know, software for VMware, for Hyper-V, not all of them provide this kind of a functionality. So it's a huge, fantastic value, okay? Of course, we can also say, like here, that I am an administrator of some virtualization like Nutanix, and I say, okay, I'm adding a new virtual machine, and I add the tag, which is, for example, called production. I can also say to vProtect, backup only those virtual machines that are tagged as a production, or, for example, that have in the name the word MariaDB, or whatever else doesn't matter, okay? So it can be regular expression, whatever we want. But self-backup environment is a huge value. And guys, another great thing in vProtect, recovery plan. I can say that I want to have just one button, and when I click this one button, there will be recovered 5 virtual machines with Dockers, Kubernetes, with database, with application, with access, whatever. And it will be automatically recovered. Just one button and everything will be recovered. Further, I can schedule the recoveries. I can tell to vProtect, please restore every Monday morning databases of our CRM system to test environment. Please recover this to test environment because we need to feed test environment with current data. So we can schedule the recoveries. We can say, okay, recover the last successful backup. We recover the last backup. We will see it in a second, very flexible. a question from Basel, are tax similar to AVAMER rules? Exactly, Basel. This is absolutely the same thing. Exactly. Thank you very much for the comment. So here we see the example of the recovery plan. We say here all virtual machines we want to restore. We can add a schedule. For example, every Monday morning, we want to restore the virtual machines to a test environment. Or we don't need to add to the any schedule, so it will be on-demand restore. That it makes sense if our environment is lost, is ransomware or whatever. And here we have the restore parameters. So we can say if we want to restore to last successful backup, to hypervisor, we can also restore as the files. And below there is possibility to generate, for example, automatically the names of the recovered virtual machines. As I mentioned, on demand, it means that we restore for disaster recovery scheduled. It means that we want to periodic restore, for example, for test environment. Yeah, and here is shown that, for example, in this window, we can define which virtual machines we want to have a recovery plan. We can have a one virtual machine or two virtual machines that are restored immediately. Another thing, if virtualization platform allows us, if virtualization platform has tools like VMware has the tools, similar mechanism, then vProtect informs this platform, these tools, that there will be a backup and it performs a snapshot, quite a snapshot inside the virtual machine. This is available for Citrix, for Red Hat, for Nutanix. We also have pre and post scripts. So if you have a MariaDB, MySQL, you want to have it consistent inside when the image is backup or snapshot is performed, because we need to remember we have two types of backup based on the image or that is really transferred to some media like data domain or disk, or we can have a snapshots that are kept on the virtualization platform. For both of them, we can have a commands that are pre and post this one, so we can make any database, any application in a backup mode, no problem. Of course, as we said, vProtect supports data domain. vProtect supports data domain as a one of two backup media, which is, of course, data domain and which is disk as well. If we use data domain as a backup media, we have, of course, source deduplication. Then we have a source deduplication. If we backup Nutanix, we have node on a Nutanix, then from the Nutanix to data domain, there will be source deduplication, which is fantastic thing. We have then, of course, minimal network usage, and we have a huge speed. Guys, I need to tell you, I have on Tuesday conversation with customer, and this customer, this is off topic, has DD9800. And this customer achieved a speed 86 terabytes per hour. I couldn't believe it. I looked for the data twice, 86 terabytes per hour. Yeah, customer. So incredible, yeah, incredible. Data domain is of course a speed. So this is what we get. Of course, minimal cost. Because we have, of course, the duplication. So all the vProtect backups, they are deduplicated. But we have as well global deduplication. So it means that if we backup OVIRT as an image, and then we backup from inside, from networker, net backup, some, I don't know, files, MariaDB. So the second backup does not cost us on data domain any additional money, any additional space, because the data are already there. So we can have an image level on vProtect, because vProtect is image level backup. And we have guest level to the data domain, and the space will be the same. Of course, shorter backup window. Because of data domain, we have just one phase backup. In case of disk, we have 2 days backup. And speed is all from this one phase backup, as well from the duplication and small network use. And of course, simple architecture, because one phase backup is, of course, simple. And we need to remember that source deduplication and vProtect, they are in the same license bundle, which is called PowerProtect license bundle. So vProtect is part of PowerProtect license bundle. So we don't buy vProtect as a standalone solution. We can purchase vProtect as a whole PowerProtect bundle. There are a couple of solutions, a lot of solutions, I would say. Two of them is vProtect and BoostFS. So source deduplication to the data domain, we have it. And of course, the duplication is only with data domain as a target, physical or virtual. Let me summarize all the functionalities. This is all the features of VProtect, all the platforms it supports, all the versions it supports. So what do we have? We have, of course, a full backup. We have, of course, a full backup, which is a normal one. We can take image of OVIRT, KVM, Red Hat, Xen, Citrix, Oracle, Nutanix. We can have image of those virtual machines and send them to Discord data domain. We can also have incremental backup with usage CBT if the platform provides this, like Citrix. If we have a full backup, so this is a mountable backup, we can restore a single file. So in this case, the full backup is mounted on a node on a VProtect, and we can browse it and we can say, okay, I want to recover this directory, this file to some virtual machine. We can also have mounting disks on a platform from the backup. So in this case, VProtect, the node of the VProtect, just takes one of the disks and shows via iSCSI to virtualization platform, Nutanix, OVIRT, Red Hat, and so on, shows it as a disk, and then we can attach it to any virtual machine. Further, we have a disk occlusion. So we can say, okay, I have 10 virtual disks in a virtual machine. I want to backup only 5 of them because rest, there are, for example, installation files or something which does not matter, temp area or whatever. This is self-backup environment. We can say that we want to backup every new virtual machine that has been created on our OVIRT, Xen, Oracle, Proxmos, or whatever, any virtual platform. Yes, we can say it. So, or we can say we want to backup all MySQL virtual machines or tagged virtual machine as a production. Okay, so this is self-backup environment. Absolutely great thing. Commands, pre and post backup, pre and post snapshots. And guys, this is a regular backup like we have in a backup software. So we take image from Proxmos, OVIRT, Red Hat, Nutanix, and so on, and we send to data domain or a disk. But we can have just snapshots that we keep on the Red Hat, KVM, Nutanix, and so on. We can just create snapshots and keep them on the virtual machines, okay? But of course, if the hardware, you know, disappears, then snapshots disappear. So we need to have this type of backup periodically as well. Question from Mohamed: does this offer granular restore, for example, file restore? Absolutely, yes. Guys, so let's go to the GUI. As we have mentioned, we have HTML5 interface, GUI interface. We have, of course, command line, REST API. But the interface is very nice, very easy. You see that I have one virtual machine, which is protected. I don't have any unprotected virtual machines. I can add hypervisor. Currently, I have just only added a Proxmos hypervisor. I can add any additional hypervisor. For example, hypervisor 2, I can choose the hypervisor and add it, of course. If I added the hypervisor, it automatically scans for the virtual machines and I can see virtual machines. And if there is any virtual machine, I can just backup on demand. Okay, I can backup now or I can backup at 8 p.m. Why? For example, I will be in the cinema, so I will be busy. I don't want to, you know, be disturbed. So in this case, you know, it will just start at the backup at 8 p.m. So let's start. Let's start this backup. Okay. If we start this backup, the backup has been initiated. If we can, of course, watch, very nice, watch it's currently queued. When the backup starts, we will see the process here, which is currently running, and we will see the progress of the backup in the percentage. Very nice, very easy interface, showing everything, very intuitive one. We can, of course, also see the backup progress here. We see that the backup is going on. We also see the source deduplication. You see the more data are read. As an image in this Proxmos, much fewer data has been sent to the data domain. Okay. And as I mentioned, we have also possibility to create automated policy for backup, for snapshot, as I mentioned, and for recovery. So I can say, I want to create a recovery plan. Let's create a recovery plan. For example, recovery plan 3. Okay, so I have created it. Then I can add some rules, what I want to backup, so rule three as well, I can say that in this recovery plan, I want to restore Proxmox virtual machines. And if there is five virtual machines, I can restore all virtual machines, all five virtual machines at the same time. No, in my case, I have only one, but I can select all. Schedule, so I can say, okay, I want that this recovery plan will be started automatically on Monday morning, because this will be a data for test environment. So I want to restore five virtual machines with databases for test environment, or if I don't give any schedule, it won't be any schedule. In this case, probably I want to be ready for disaster, for some attack, ransomware, for some deletion of the data. In one button, I will be able to restore the whole environment. In restore parameters, I can say, okay, I want to restore from last successful backup or last backup, even if it failed. Probably doesn't make sense, but I'm free person, so I can do that. I can restore to the hypervisor. I can restore to file system. If I restore to the hypervisor, I just provide which hypervisor I want to restore. And I can say, okay, generate virtual machine's name automatically, for example. Okay, and that's all. I just saved it. And then if I click our recovery plan three, it will be automatically recovered. Yeah. Apart from GUI, there is also REST API and command line. And command line is really fantastic. I would say like data domain. Look, there is just one command vprotect and additional commands with explanation, which we can do. And just one example, vprotect virtual machines list. And look, we have all virtual machines on the hypervisor. If there is in backup policy or not, is it protected when there is a last backup? Guys, you know, in this case, I would even prefer this against the GUI. GUI is also fantastic. It's HTML5, very nice, very easy. But all the required info in nice manner immediately. Really great. Someone has really developed it in fantastic way. I'm really under a huge impression. A question from Basel, is this the protected VMs? This ones. So this is all the virtual machines on the hypervisor that we added. If anyone wants to try vprotect, we can get binaries from support.com. Trial license can be provided by us, no problem. And as I mentioned, support.com, if you go to vprotect section, drivers and downloads, you can download the binaries. There is not a problem. Question from Christian, how vprotect is licensed? Vprotect is part of PowerProtect bundle. And this PowerProtect bundle consists of vprotect software, consists BoosterFest, source deduplication for data domain, okay? And the license is either per terabyte of protected environment or per physical processor. So if I have three Red Hat and two Nutanix servers, I have five servers. If every one of them has two processors, I need 10 licenses, okay? Because five physical servers, 10 physical processors, so I would need 10 licenses in this case. Guys, we go to the quiz. Question number one, what virtual environments can vprotect backup? Yes, OVIRT, KVM, Nutanix, Oracle, Red Hat, Xen, Citrix, Proxmox, OpenStack. Question number two, what type of backups can we perform using vprotect? Yes, image level backup, directly to media, data domain, or disk, VM snapshot that are kept on the virtualization platform. Absolutely. Question number three, can we have self-backup environment in vprotect? Guys, the most important part, self-backup environment. Here there is answer. I think it's exaggeration. People are lazy and don't want to work. No, it's not the fact that we don't want to work. Self-backup environment. So this is something that guarantees me that all the virtual machines are protected. If I say to vprotect backup all Proxmox, Nutanix, Red Hat, OVIRT, KVM, virtual machines at 6 p.m. Yes, all will be protected in case of any issue, disaster, ransomware, I'm secure. So we can automatically backup based on the tags or names. What interface does vprotect provide? So what kind of interface do we have in vprotect? We have touched those interfaces, yes. GUI, based on HTML5. REST API, we didn't touch it, and command line. Command line, of course, we touch. It's very, very nice one. Question five, what backup media does vprotect support? What backup media do we have available? Is it disk, is it CD-ROM, is it data domain? Thank you very much for all correct answers. Absolutely, disk and data domain, BoosterFS. almost last question, why does it make sense to consider data domain as backup media for vProtect? Absolutely. Why? One phase backup, source the duplication, short backup window. Last question, guys. What is the license package that contains vProtect? Yes, PowerProtect. It also contains both. Please remember, PowerProtect license package has a lot of things, but two of them, this is vProtect and also BoostFS, which is a source deduplication for data domain. From my side is everything. Thank you very much for the fun. Thank you very much for the discussion. I encourage you to interest with vProtect. Very nice solution.